Okay, guys, it is 2:01. Welcome, welcome. We're going to go ahead and get started. I want to be respectful of Brandon's time because he only has 30 minutes to share with us today, and I'm just excited that we get him at all. He is amazing. If you've been around for any amount of time, I'm sure you know who Brandon Barber is, but he is a personal coach. He's all about mindset. He does all kinds of trainings for groups, for large groups. He does in-person trainings that are amazing called Infinite Potential. I mean, there are several of them that he'll probably tell you about. But he was my personal coach for a while. I want to say it was a couple of years ago, but I went to several events and worked with him one-on-one. He is incredible. Because the biggest thing that he does for people is help them work on their mindset and just to find joy in the journey. And you guys know we're always talking about that. Like, if you don't love what you're doing, then you need to either figure out a way to love it or you got to find something else. And he is amazing at asking the hard questions and coaching people to be able to do that, find joy, whatever it is that they're doing. So I'm going to hand it over to Brandon because he's going to talk to us about a really important topic today. And while he's doing that, I will let everybody in from the waiting room. Welcome, Brandon.
Thanks. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it, Gina. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put, because I want to see your guys' chats. So, but I don't know this because I'm on my phone. So when I do that, can you still see me? Mm-hmm. Can you guys see me when I do that? Like, can you see me right now?
Yes.
Okay, good. Good. Cool. Because I want to see your chat section. And I'm using my phone today. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm like moving from one thing to the next. So I wanted to make sure that we got you this information because it's so powerful. And Gina asked if I jump on today. And so thank her for whatever breakthroughs or ahas or anything that you have today as a result of what we share. If you don't, if you like don't get anything, then you can blame me. Then you can text me or email me and tell me, hey, that was lame. But this concept, and I'll give you guys a heads up on Facebook. There is a call, because we did a call last night. We did a full hour call and then we recorded it. So if you in any way, shape or form, sorry guys, I know it's so lame.
Did we lose you completely, Brandon?
I think we did. He'll be back.
I'll end up back in the waiting room. I'll have to let him back in. The waiting room off this time, but apparently I didn't. Oh, there he is. There you are.
Okay, guys, I'm so sorry about that. Like, you'd think I'd know how to use Zoom at this point, right? Like, come on. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Let's go. We'll go from, hey, I, if anybody is listening to this and they're like, this guy knows what he's talking about 100%. He has no problems. He has no issues. Like, this guy's got it together. Like, you are in the wrong place because that is not true. In fact, the topic today, I'm going to tell you, I'm struggling with myself right now. So in no way, shape or form am I here to tell you how to, you know, just follow everything I tell you to do and it's going to cure you forever. So hopefully you get that, man. And Gina can tell you or anybody else who's done work with us, that guy's got issues for sure. I do. I was telling you on Facebook, we have a, we did a call last night and the call is on Facebook. It's recorded. So it's a full hour. I probably won't get everything covered in the next 30 minutes that I did last night, but I'm going to do my best to roll it out, get everything and just give you the meat and potatoes of things in 30 minutes for sure. But if you want to go listen to the recording, it's on Facebook, BrandonBarberCoaching.com. We don't list it there. That's our website. I'm trying to think like the Brandon Barber Coaching Group, or if you're a friend of mine, or you can friend me, I guess, or follow Brandon Barber Coaching and then you'll see it there. So that's the way to do it. And the recording's all there, but this is all about a topic that is sort of new. It's like a new concept. And it came out of what's gone on over the last year and a half. So let me ask you guys a question, and I want you to answer and answer via chat, because I can see your chats. And I want, because I want to get your feedback. So what's your excitement level right now of 2021? I mean, we saw all of the memes, right, on social media about 2020 is going to be over and ring in 2021. And yes, we're so excited for 2021 and pumped up and ready to go. And 2021 is like this awesome, amazing, incredible excitement place. Like, we can't wait for it to be here. How many of you are like, yes, it's here, finally, 2021? And for most people, it's going to be, no, like, I'm not super excited. Like, it's, my excitement's not there. It's at a medium excitement, okay? Honestly, I'm at a 7. 7's higher than most people. In the middle, all right? Pretty stoked, Sarah, that's awesome. Like, I don't hear that very often. I can tell you, until I started practicing a few things, which I'll give you today, I was not at an 8. Another day, another dollar. How many of you are like right in the middle? Like, it's like, I'm not really at that high level. I'm not like super excited. I'm not on fire. I'm not out killing it. I'm not like doing all these amazing things. It's been low, or it is low, or I'm struggling, or I'm not really at that place. Well, here's what we know. If you have this, like, and I'm curious, you can raise your hand, you can put in the quotes or the chat, like, do you feel a little bit of a lack of sense of purpose and fulfillment? Have joy and other sort of simple pleasures lost their meaning? Is there more of a feeling of like blah, or I see the memes all the time, meh, right? If you watch the emoji movie, if you have kids that age, like young kids, and you watch the emoji movie, then you know the main character is meh, right? And that's kind of what, where we're at, where most people are. Is blah, blah. Yeah, for sure. Joyless, aimlessness, dull. Dull's a, the mood is dull. That's a good one, Barbara. Absolutely. Putting yourself on hold. For me, I was like putting myself on hold for something, waiting for something amazing to show up, waiting for my purpose to show up, waiting for my joy to show up. But I was like on hold. That was kind of my feeling. Tired. Maybe it's even seeing things like brains. I got a lot of clients that would tell me, gosh, we have this Alzheimer's in our family, or what other, trying to think of the, you know, diseases you get when you're older. Like, we have these things in our family, and I'm wondering if I'm not in that space. And I heard that more and more and more and more and more. But this feeling of, you know, kind of being stuck. It's like the void between flourishing and excitement or depression, or sorry, the void between flourishing or excitement and depression. It's not quite depression, but it's not flourishing. And the term is coined languishing. And it was coined by, I have a couple of notes here because I got to remember this guy's name. He was a sociologist. His name's Corey Keyes. And he was struck that all these people weren't depressed, but I'll say that they weren't really flourishing. And I started to do this research about 4 months ago and started to like, what's going on? Because I was wanted to know what was going on in my own head. Like, what's happening? Because I wasn't functioning at my full capacity in any way, shape, or form. I had like, I getting out of bed was like, I normally got out of bed and jump out of bed. And then it was like snooze, snooze, snooze. And I end up kind of laying there for a while. And I was like, what is going on? Am I depressed? Am I like, what is this stuff? Do I need to go like check out what's going on? And listen, languishing, this concept of languishing, if you have signs of depression or signs of anxiety, or you've had anxiety or depression in the past, languishing is probably going to go up tremendously. I've struggled with anxiety my whole life. Languishing like takes on, it's like 3 times what it is for maybe other people. But it's this like concept of like, not, it's stagnation, it's emptiness, it's not really at your full capacity, right? And here's the breakdown of this languishing. The term is languishing, and it might be the predominant emotion of 2021. And there's some dangers of it down the road, which I want to share with you in just a minute. But in the early days of COVID, right, in this uncertainty we had around this pandemic, it's likely that your brain, your amygdala, the part of your brain that creates fight, flight, or freeze, it's threat. It knew to detect some threat. Even if you're like, hey, it wasn't that big a deal. I'm out in the middle of nowhere. Like, I just hung out. My life didn't change much. Brain still thought there was a threat. It picked up on the threat. It's like for me living in Salt Lake City, Utah in 2001, September 11th, right? It's 2001, wasn't it? I'm like, was that right? But 9/11, you remember 9/11? Like, I'm in Salt Lake City, Utah. I'm so far away from New York City, but man, that still had a major impact on me. Like, I didn't see any of it except on TV. I wasn't there. I didn't whip, but I still had that threat. That threat was still there. And in the pandemic, we had threat detection that got kicked in. Our amygdala was kicked in. It was on high alert. Even if we weren't actually experiencing panic ourselves, it was there. Now, along the way, you found things that worked and you found things that didn't work, right? You found, hey, this works for me, this works for me. And you developed routines. And those routines, they diminished that sense of dread, right? Maybe the routine for you was reading. Maybe it was growing, doing growth, self-development or growth things at the time. Maybe it was going for walks in nature. For sure, I spent a lot of time in nature. I spent more time, you know, outside than any time in the history of my life, I think, over the last year and a half. That was a place I went. And it eased my sense of dread. But the pandemic has dragged on. Like, it dragged on and it dragged on and it dragged on. And the acute state of anguish, I want you to think about that. An acute state of anguish, and it's not just the pandemic that could have created this. It could be anything. But that's what's gone on for the year and a half. And that acute state of anguish has given way to a chronic condition, and this chronic condition is called languishing. And languishing dulls your motivation. It disrupts your ability to focus. It's like looking through a foggy windshield. It triples the odds that you'll cut back on work. In fact, just regular day-to-day work. In fact, even companies that are like they're making lots of money. They're productive. They're doing like really well in the pandemic. Even their productivity is down. Their money might be up, but their productivity of their employees is down. This is crazy. It's like 40% down in the workplace. So chances of people on your team cutting back on work, chances of you cutting back on work are going to be pretty high. How many of you said, I must be a lousy leader because I can't get my team to go do what they're going to do? Or I've watched this leg shrink, or I've watched productivity shrink, or I've watched my OGV shrink or whatever. And you blamed yourself and you went, I'm a lousy leader. Anybody do that? What if it's not you? What if this is languishing? Now, I don't say that so you're like, okay, so let's just give it some label and then just walk away from it. No way, shape, or form. But what if it's not you? What if it's this languishing thing? And people aren't just excited. Listen, 4 months ago, I'm like, we're doing all this stuff. We switched into gears and started doing all these new events. And I started to pump people up. And I'm like, where are people at? They're not pumped up. They're not doing anything. So I did my own research and I started to find out, hey, this languishing thing it's a real thing. The assessment, if you guys haven't taken our assessment, one of the areas in our assessment, it's a brain assessment. It tells us where you're at in the brain, where you're thinking and how you're thinking, the advice you're getting. One of the areas in there is called joy in the journey. And I started noticing that score. I looked and that score was down dramatically, dramatically, dramatically over, you know, so much time frame. So I did my own research and I said, let's take 2000 assessments over the last 3 months and let's find out. Let's find out what the joy in the journey score is. And then let's take 2000 assessments from, I thought 2000 was a pretty big number, right? Let's take 2000 assessments from pre-COVID and let's find out where joy in the journey score was. And here's what we found out. the Join the Journey score, and you don't know much about these scores or what they mean, but I'm going to tell you this is significant. Join the Journey. The score pre-COVID, the average score was 72. No, that's not fantastic, but before pre-COVID, people weren't finding a lot of joy in the journey. They were struggling with things, but now it's 60. So the average has gone down 12 points, which in my world, significant, like out of this world significant, a 12 point drop over an average, something's gone on. So we've done our own research, languishing, right? And it shows up. I'm wondering when it shows up for you. Like I wrote down some things. Where does languishing show up for me? It shows up for me when I go for a run and I'm let down. Like I go for my morning run and I'm let down, or I don't make it to my morning run and it's my afternoon run and I'm let down. That's how I see languishing show up. Like I'm like, it used to just give me this feeling like I'm on fire. Like I go for the run and I'm like, I'm good for the day. And I'm deflated because it doesn't give me that same excitement. It shows up in my kids' voices when I ask them how school's going or how life is going. It shows up in their voices, and I can tell it shows up in their body language. It's in that meh, you know, when my wife's like, let's go to dinner. And I'm like, I don't know. And she's like, we've been locked down for so long. Restaurants are open. Let's go to dinner. And I'm like, That's when it shows up for me. When does it show up for you? Like, when is this languishing showing up in your life? When your daughter calls it, my give a crap is broken. My give a crap is broken. Okay. All right. Yeah. I'm curious. When does it show up? When does languishing show up for you? Is it when you watch other people? How does it show up for other people? How do you see it in other people? Is it their desire to work their business or not work their business and give you every excuse in the world why they don't? I could have given you 4 months ago, 6 months ago, I could have told you every reason why our business is struggling and we can't go to live events, and all this stuff, right? Shows up when my husband lost a job and life was sucked out of me. Absolutely, Melanie, I feel for you. Yeah, I see people not getting back out to life. Social hermits. Yeah, absolutely. We have an in-person event, legit in-person. We haven't done one for a year and a half. And we have one in Texas. We have one in the Fort Worth area. It's called The Power of You. It's working on all of this stuff, a live event in Texas. And I thought, and the people that were putting it on, there's like 12 diamonds putting it on. They're like, Brandon, you got to get a room of like 500 people for sure. Cause people cannot wait to get out and do a live event. And I'm like, okay. 500 people, huh? And I'm like, maybe, right? Sure enough, it's not 500 people. It's in 2 weeks and there are not 500 people registered. There's not even half that. People have become hermits, for sure. In fact, that's one of the biggest dangers. The biggest dangers that I've noticed is when you're in languishing, you might not notice the doling. You might not, I didn't notice when I was like doling or not finding the delight or telling my wife, let's not go out for dinner. She's like, I'm not cooking one more meal. But for me, it was like, I didn't even notice the dwindling drive until it got severe. It was day to day and it got to a place where it almost felt like depression, right? It was that's the danger in this languishing thing is it's so slow that people aren't aware of it. It's a big danger. And then it could lead to bigger things. So you don't catch yourself slipping in this place. You just know it's just kind of a funk. Like it's just kind of a funk and I'm not quite sure. Meh. But the slow decline will lead to deeper and more dangerous things. In fact, I looked at some studies. I dug up a bunch of studies last night, the day before. And here's what I found. Studies show that those that were languishing in the spring of 2020 were 3 times more likely than their peers to be diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder. 3 times. In fact, here's some interesting statistics done on the World Health Organization. They predict that depression will be the number one cause of burden in every single country in the world by 2030. The number one cause of depression and the source of it, we're looking at it, languishing. So listen, things aren't looking fantastic, right? Now, that's a prediction. That's it. And I am not a, like, hey, this prediction thing is what you got to follow. I'm like, let's do something about it. Let's solve this solution. So 4 months ago, I started really digging in. How do we solve these solutions? Right. And the good news. Yes. I remember, I'll never forget whenever I hear that statement. And the good news is, I remember going, I'm a big river rafter. I love river rafting. And we do a lot of different rivers throughout the years. I've done them throughout the years. And I remember doing a river, I was probably 28, maybe. And it was a river called Hell's Canyon. And it's literally, it's deep, it's a deeper descent than the Grand Canyon. And you go do this, it's on the Snake River. It's called Hell's Canyon. And you have to meet with the ranger before, you have to have a permit to do the river, all that stuff. But we're sitting there meeting with the ranger, right? Me and all of my friends and the people that were on that, doing that river. And here's what the ranger said. The river's at an all-time high. In fact, class threes are now fours, fours are fives, and fives are unrunnable. And you have four of them on this stretch. And I'm like, whoa, okay. And they're like, rattlesnakes are in full effect. They are out. They are everywhere. Like rattlesnakes, they are everywhere. They are all over the place. It is completely dry. You're not going to see much that's green. It is the dry environment. You can't have any fires at night. No fires at night because, and that's like, gosh, we have fires on our river trips and when we're camping. Like, what are you talking about? So for the next 5 days, we're on this river that's going to be totally dry. That's going to be huge water. We can't have any river or any fires at night. And then they said, and the widows are at an all-time high, meaning not black widows, but widow spiders. And I'm like, I looked at the ranger and I'm like, where's the good news? Like, what is, like, let's turn around and go home. So that's funny when you say that, Mary. I always think about that. There is good news. And here's the good news. Just like there was good news then, I was on a river. I got to go spend time with friends. There's good news now. The good news is this, that we can do something about it. And I've actually done something about it in my own life and solidified something that works. So I didn't just roll this out to you and go, here are the things that you do. Here's the go-to. I've lived them in my own life. I'm using them with my clients. I'm giving them to my clients and they're working. They're phenomenal. If you look at the clients that we're working with right now, you'll see a dramatic difference. They're not freaking out about things. They're not in a met. They're actually making stuff happen. You'll see them online. You'll see them engaged only because they're using the same tools that I've used because I got stuck in this languishing big time. And so here's the tools and I'm going to give them to you. Number one, there's a concept called flow. And those of you that have worked with me long enough or have worked with me at all, you know this concept of flow. Flow is about being in the present moment. There's a book called Rise of Superman. Don't go buy it. I'll tell you what it means. The Rise of Superman is about adventure athletes and adventure athletes doing what they do and why do they do it? They do what they do because they like to get into flow. It's not adrenaline that they like to get into. It's flow. Flow puts, it's like this perfect chemical in the brain, the right amount of norepinephrine, the right amount of dopamine, the right amount of serotonin. And they feel amazing afterwards. That's why they go ride 60-foot waves. That's why they jump out of airplanes. That's why they climb rock walls 3,000 feet above the ground without a rope. They do these things to get in a state of flow. And something has to happen to get into flow. You have to be present. You have to be in the moment. And when you're an adventure athlete and you're getting ready to ride a 60-foot wave, what happens? Brain shuts everything else off except that moment. And they get into so much focus and into that moment so much that it creates this this perfect chemical. I don't want to call it a storm because it's not a storm, a perfect chemical cocktail in the brain. It's called flow, being in the present moment. How present are you? How much, and we've been teaching this for years, and I'm like, oh my gosh, the cure's flow. Flow is a cure, absolute cure. Getting in the moment. You go, Brandon, I'm not going to jump out of an airplane. I'm not going to ride a 60-foot wave. Okay, fair enough. But you can practice what are called power sessions. Those are blocks of time where you just focus on one thing. But start getting in the mindset of training your brain to get focused on one thing. But now it's not just doing it to stay present. It's not just doing it because you know it's good for you. You're doing it to move out of languishing. And all of a sudden, when you do that, it has a different impact. Okay, so that's number one. There's more. Number two, getting a sense of progress, feeling a sense of progress. So tell me, how many of you are doing things that are getting you a sense of progress? I'm moving forward. And I hear a lot of people tell me all about their hobbies, but what if your business right now is actually good for languishing? And you go, well, my business isn't progressing, Brandon. I'm looking at the numbers and they're not progressing. But what about you progressing? What about you taking action? Not in the numbers, but you doing something a little bit every day. And doing things that are the most challenging are going to be the biggest things that release the most endorphins and the most, the right chemicals in your brain. Let's just put it that way, so I don't get scientific. But by doing those little things that give you progress, doing things that are moving you forward, what are those things? One foot in front of another, right? Three, community. Community is critical. I remember when I looked at this 4 or 5 months ago, my community was my wife, my kids, and only three of my kids, because one of them he's in another state and was in another country, and so couldn't even be around it, right? So it was me and my three kids and all the characters in Schitt's Creek, right? That was my community. For those of you who don't know, it's a TV show. Maybe that's your community. It's been something on Netflix, right? What's your community been like? Getting into community, moving into community, critical, right? Tough to do when everywhere you go, somebody's got a mask on. Community. And number four, gratitude, right? Now you go, gratitude. I know I'm supposed to be in gratitude. Are you practicing gratitude? Are you actually practicing? And that recording that you can go check out in on Facebook that we did, you'll see a recording of us doing a gratitude exercise. It's not just writing in your journal every day what you're grateful for. It's actually practicing gratitude every day. And that's tough to do, right? In a space where you're languishing. Again, the danger is it kind of lulls you into this. It's not like one day you're like, ah, I'm crying and I'm in tears and I'm depressed. It's like, meh. And so it lulls you into this space. And danger, because again, what's happening to your productivity? What's happening to your connections with people? And you're like, oh, and it's the government. Well, we can blame the government all we want, or we can go, what can we do about it? Gratitude. The concept of have, do, be. And you might not know what I mean by that, but have, do, be gets people really stuck. If I'm have this, I could do this and I could be this. And I'm going to tell you, a solution is to reverse that. Be, do, have. And you might go, well, I don't necessarily know what you're talking about. You don't necessarily need to. What I want to do is I want to give you a lifeline. Because I went through these things and you can practice these things on your own, but I know you need the emotional mastery internally to get these things. So I'm going to throw you a lifeline and it's up to you to take advantage of this. We have two events. I've created an event called The Power of You that's designed directly with you in mind and this concept in mind. And we have one event we're doing live. It's in Texas. It's in 2 weeks. It's on a Saturday. It's a one-day event. And then we have an event, a virtual event that we're doing. And this isn't a Zoom call. It is a virtual event. It feels like you're at an event. If any of you have attended our recent virtual event, we've done two. We got all the bugs worked out, so it works really smooth now. But the last one we did, 3 days, game changer for people. They loved it. Last night, people were on that call and they're like, I'm not in med. I'm not in this place after attending this virtual event. Because what I hear from people is, I don't want another Zoom call. We have another Zoom to get community. We've created an environment that literally helps you feel like you're part of a community and part of an experience, part of a 3-day event. And it's yes, it's online and you're doing it at your house, but it feels like it's like you're there, right? And we worked with the best people in the industry, the people who taught Tony Robbins and Grant Cardone and Eric Worre, the big names, the people that pay millions of dollars to have this company teach them how to do virtual events. We actually spent 3 days with them learning how to do these virtual events. So again, this is a lifeline for you guys to attend two events or one of those events. One is in June. It's a virtual event. It's called The Power of You. The other one is in Texas. Literally, and I'll put let me see if I have this up here. If I can paste this. I don't know. I can't seem to see it. It's brandonbarbercoaching.com. So if you go to brandonbarbercoaching.com, you can actually see these events live in person. They're there. You can register for these events. but thank you for putting that up there. I appreciate it. And there's a section on events, and you'll see the one in Texas and you'll see the virtual event. Texas event's 2 weeks away. The virtual event is in June. Guys, they're ridiculously inexpensive. We made them ridiculously inexpensive for you to attend. So that's my lifeline to get these things, these principles into your body, because mastery comes in lots of forms, but three really. Number one, cognitive. We know it. Now you know. Languishing, it's real. It's legit. Go do the research. It's out there. There's so much stuff on it that you'll go, whoa, okay, this is, now I can call it something. I know what it is. Languishing, right? I know it. And I know how to get out of it. Brandon's just given me the tools to get out of it. But have I emotionally mastered how to get out of it? Am I practicing it? You know how to live in gratitude, but are you practicing it? In these tools, in these lifelines that we give you, we're going to help you practice it, right? Really practice getting into that space of gratitude, getting into that space of community. It'll feel like you're in a community there. Getting into that sense of progress. We'll get deeper so we can go deeper and have you start experiencing them. Now, I'm going to give you all the gifts that I gave those guys yesterday. So here's what, I had to write them down because I was like, what did I give everybody? If you will let us, and I know this is a tough place because it's like, meh, I don't want to go to an event. I don't want to do anything. I don't have the energy to do it. I know it's tough, right? But if you feel like, hey, I'd like to start flourishing, I'd love to earn the right to help you start flourishing. So these events, I'm going to give you a little push, little shove, because decisiveness turns out is a really important piece to get out of this languishing, being decisive. Because how many of you have not been super decisive recently? For me, for sure. I'm like, I've wavered on, I don't know how many things. I've sat on the fence about a million things. And it's like, what's going on? Like, I'm usually really decisive. So I'm going to kind of push you to be a little decisive. So here's what I'm going to do. If you sign up for one of these events by Friday at midnight, that's tomorrow. We're going to give you all these bonuses. Here's the bonuses we're going to give you. I'm going to give you the motivation series on video. So how to get yourself motivated, the whole have, do, be thing that I talked about. I'm going to give you those tools. So you're going to learn how to reverse the be, do, have. I'm going to give you that whole series on video. It's like $200 value and you're going to get it for free. You're going to get, what else are we giving you? There's other things. Oh, we're giving you, the gratitude exercise actually on video as well. So we're going to give you that as a bonus as well. So you'll be able to practice gratitude. And then you get a call next Wednesday at 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. We're doing an hour call with a smaller group of people who have just decided that they want to take one of these lifelines and go forward and do something with us. So if you do it, you'll get this call next Wednesday at 8 p.m. It's just a deeper dive into languishing and some of the things to start doing and start getting the kickstart, especially if you're signing up for June and you don't want to wait till June to have some breakthroughs. So next Wednesday, we're going to do a private call for you. Those are all the bonuses we give to you if you register for one of our events by midnight Friday. So guys, 35 minutes, man, I would like to spend 2 hours with you and really dig into this in more detail. We will next Wednesday if you decide you want to come be part of this, but let us help you. Let us help you get out of this space. If you really feel like you're in this languishing, not great space, let us help you work through it. Let us help you move through it and shift through it. And we will do those in those two areas. So if you're close to Texas, I would tell you get there. If you're not close to Texas or you don't want to go anywhere and you want to stay in your house, do the virtual event, but let us help you dig deeper into this to really get out of it. Cause you know, as well as I do, you're not just going to get out of it just to get out of it, right? Brain has maybe habitually got there and got into a stuck space, but we've done so much research on it and so much work around it that we have a solution. So guys, we look forward to working with you. And Gina, thank you for letting us come here. Thanks for inviting me. Talk to everybody. And I would just tell you guys, remember, success is a conscious choice. So is flourishing. So is joy. So is passion. So is love. So is connection. So is gratitude. So choose wisely. And we'll see you guys soon.
Thank you, Brandon.
You're welcome. Take care.
Thank you. So I think that event, he said 2 weeks, right? So that would be the weekend, that one that's in Texas, that would be the weekend of the 21st. I need to look it up to see if it is. Is that?
It's the 15th.
Oh, it is?
Mm-hmm. It's next weekend.
Oh.
It's, Brandon, it's a 1 week baby.
I'm gonna have to, might have to rearrange some stuff. I was planning to do a spa night that night at Well Okay, but
yeah,
rearrange some stuff because I just got all fired up listening to him. He is so good, and his in-person events are so good. If I would have known the practical application that I was gonna have to do at his event, though, like my personality is like, I'm not gonna do that. Like, I just want to sit there and absorb all the information and decide what I want to use or whatever. Usually that's just my safe. That's how I'm me feeling safe. And you have to get up and do stuff like over and over and over. And it's good. And it's not that hard. Like, it's because you're there with your friends, you're there with people that you love and you trust, and everyone else is doing it, but it's impactful. I'm telling you, it's crazy. And when he was talking, all the stuff was flooding back that I just needed to be reminded of, especially about how he delineates like your brain from you. That was a huge turning point for me when I realized that like I was taking on all these characteristics that really it was just my brain or like my subconscious preventing me from doing things that, and when I could separate it and be like, oh, that's just my brain. I can tell my brain to shut up, you know, and get in line or whatever. Then it just really helped me to change my mindset. So anyways, I'm all fired up after listening to him. And how many of you were encouraged by the fact that like every single person, even him, I mean, like he feels the same thing that we're feeling. Like, I don't know how many times Sunshine, I don't know if she's ever been discouraged in her life, but like the I work closely with like bounce, like once a week, probably one of us is having to get the other one in line. Like, thankfully we're not usually all on the same day, like languishing.
That'd be a disaster.
or one of us is languishing less. So then like, if you're really down, then I'm able to be like, insert a little bit of positivity or vice versa. But I mean, it's just so refreshing to hear him like, say he went through the same thing, the mindset, you know?
And I feel like last year, I like to crunch numbers. I even crunched numbers with our farm and sent them all to Jason yesterday from March 2020 to March 2021, because we just completed, you know, that season. And we saw a trend of like people that were kind of almost in this like really protective mode when things first started happening, like, figure it out, protect, be on guard, be aware, like that's kind of the posture. And then as this has progressed and has went on in our society and our culture, people are now at that languish stage. It's like we had been in this protect fight mode in our like being for so long that our bodies probably just like checked out. I mean, I don't know how long you can actually be in that state. I can't speak into that, but I can just see the progression of this is how we started out. And we just stayed in that mode for too long, for too many days and too many months. And now we're kind of on the other side of that, of just like the languishing part. And you can see it when you go out in the world in general. So for a lot of people, like for me, I'm an empath. I'm totally empathetic. I'm super sensitive to my environment. Especially if I'm in a space with a lot of people, I can pick up on the husband and wife that are arguing. I can pick up on the mom that's frustrated with their kiddos that day. You know, I can just pick up on all sorts of things. And I have found myself wanting to be more, and I'm extroverted as well, but I've found myself wanting to like stay home more just to protect myself from all of the emotions that people are having right now that are just, you know, negative and myself included.
For me, I found, I didn't put these words to it or anything, but it seemed like everybody was so taxed and they were so tired when the pandemic started. Everybody relished the time to be home and be resting and not be social. And we've now gotten in a habit, I know I have gotten in a habit of being home, of like having this little small corner of my world, and that's not doing my business any favors, you know? So coming out of that and figuring out, and I love that he gave us those tools because now we have something to look forward to. I know that Gina's done coaching with him. I've done coaching with him. So it's like, oh yeah, he taught us this stuff. Like, this is a fantastic reminder of what I can be doing for myself and help others too. And then of course, Brandon, he is always making things better and being able to come up with new tools to help people move to that next level. So I'm really grateful for this. Thank you for setting it up, Gina.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm so glad that we did this, and I'm gonna watch his call. I'm sure it's very similar, but it's more, he goes into more detail, the one last night. I don't know if any of you guys saw that, but he said it's on his page if we wanna go to it and learn more about it. But I mean, Tiffany and Sunshine might get mad at me about spa night, but I'm seriously considering, like, I feel like it's probably more important for me to do something like that at this moment than to try to cultivate community, which I mean, I'm always trying to do that, but like try from not a full space yet. I'm getting there, like, but I just feel like I need to be filled up, you know? The assessment is on his website, Tina asked. And it's really telling. It's awesome. It just tells, it has several different categories and tells you where you fall on all the different. It's a really weird assessment as far as like, you have to put all these words in order, these random words that don't seem to make sense, like from like best to worst or whatever, but it's spot on whenever you get the results. Okay, do you guys have any other questions, or do you wanna end a little bit early today? What do you think? Anybody else have something they wanted to share? You can unmute if you do. Okay, well, thank you guys. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you for just sharing this time with us every single week. We love you guys. And have a great day.